Good morning, it's still 19 September 2012. In my thinking pattern, I'm on the high speed frequency. I think twice the speed I can talk. So, I try to be strict to myself. I want to make another video today about the connection between me, my file, against the Netherlands, ICC and Estonia. As you know from my videos on Urmas Haruma, he was the first man I turned to in Estonia. With great pain in my heart and my brain, I have to draw the conclusion that Urmas Haruma is still not fit enough to talk with me about his not so good behavior in relationship with my ICC law case. I asked him again last week to contact me to come to the Netherlands so we can talk and bring our relationship to a much nicer and more friendly platform. But apparently he's not ready for it, or I underestimated the evil in him. That's possible too. Estonia. Because I'm connected with Urmas Haruma, I'm also emailing the capo, the secret service of Estonia, and the president. I don't think I emailed the foreign ministry. Yeah, occasionally when I have one of my days, but it's not my regular email address. I assume that Estonia has hosted a seminar for ICC on victims, because they want to know more about what ICC has to tell next to all my emails to Estonia. The seminar took place last week and it was addressed by Tina Intelman, the president of the Assembly of State Members of the Statute of Rome. So she is the president that talks with all the state members of ICC. And then Elizabeth Rain, she is a board member for the ICC Victim Fund. Well, I have to repeat myself again. ICC has no victim fund for Europeans. The ICC Victim Fund is, in my world, an idiot system. It's very unclear what they do. They create racism law cases, and then they have racism victim care, and those victims are apparently persons who need to justify their behavior, or who are being interrogated by ICC, or have to are witnesses within ICC. It's a very strange system. Again, in the Netherlands, we do have a separate unit, victim care. And we have two parts of victim care. One is within the judicial system and the other one is outside the judicial system. But they are closely related. Our Dutch system of victim care is not working perfectly. Don't think that. But when you are a victim and you know how to work with it, you do get some support. You are not pushed aside in regular law cases. In the Netherlands, the victim organization did push me aside because I am the first woman who actually starts the Article 7-6 procedure law for court organization. That's a legal procedure we have for individuals when the president, the ministers, the secretaries, Major and Alderman, the Lawyers Association in the Netherlands, are all behaving like war criminals. And an individual can only start a law case for misconduct and crimes against humanity within the Dutch Supreme Court against our politicians and lawyers, etc. I had to do that. And that law case was thrown away by the Dutch Supreme Court, and that's why I started my ICC law case. Well, our system of victim care in the Netherlands, slachtofferhulp, did not want to help me. And that's simply because the people are not intelligently enough. And they don't want to learn. They are tax funded, you know. So many people get their job within our victim care system and they want to keep it. And they don't know what to do when they run into a woman like me, because the majority of the people have themselves tortured or killed by Dutch politicians. I think about 9,000 persons per year is the Dutch genocide. Okay, but victim care, when you are a victim of average crime in the Netherlands, of a robbery or murder or whatsoever, you can turn to the victim care system in the Netherlands, and then you will get some support on how to behave as a victim, not to get killed by people. So, although our system is not perfect, it is a system, it is accessible, it's far more transparent than the ICC victim care. The ICC victim unit most certainly does not want to take care of European persons who have no fundamental human rights, can't go to court, and are under a death threat by European politicians, European lawyers, etc. So the ICC victim fund is a racial fund guilty of ethnic cleansing. They kill the Europeans, and whatever they do with the Africans, you know, it drives me nuts. I think it's a lot of favoritism and creating invalid evidence. Go back to Libya, to the lawyer Melinda Taylor. She had a white sheet of paper and she asked the signature of the Gaddafi son, so she could make her own document that would be a part of evidence within the ICC trial. Amen. So, a lawyer, an ICC lawyer, who is supposed to take care of victims, fabricates her own evidence. Well, when all the stories are true, that victims of ICC are being misled or put under pressure or believed that they had the most wonderful opportunity of their life to fly to the Netherlands to testify and become a Dutch asylum seeker and have a Dutch life, are most certainly unreliable. I think I've lost my sentence. Or perhaps not. I always do think I lose myself, but looking back the next day, usually I'm doing a good job. So all those African victims who have worked together with ICC one way or the other can be used for the corrupt ICC games of ICC lawyers, prosecutors, registers, judges. It's unclear. There's no transparency. So I can't control what ICC is telling during seminars on victim care, but it would amaze me if they have been talking about European victims. I don't think so, because they all enjoy to murder Europeans to keep European leaders above the law. That seminar in Tallinn is also connected to the Chatham House, UK, the Chatham system. That's a kind of political system, political advisors, political investigators. I'm not so happy about it, because the Global Justice Institute in the Netherlands, that is an organizer for mass murderer together with Klingendaal, the Peace Palace, the HCSS, TNO, our professors law university board, is also working together with the Chatham House. So I need to slow down for God's sake. Always before I make a video I think through what I want to say, but my brain is moving so quickly that I I don't know how to articulate my voice. Okay, I rather see that people don't work together with the Chatham House as long as they are connected to the Global Justice Institute, the mass murder organizer of the Netherlands. That one was clear. I don't know what Estonia will do with the results of that seminar. It's far too early to say. It's 5 days ago. I sincerely hope that Estonia is not going to use it against European victims who start law cases against European leaders or Russian leaders or American leaders, because the economy is too weak for it. And as I said in one of my earlier videos, I have noticed that when I email ambassadors about the increasing violence within ICC, conducted by ICC employees, many presidents, ambassadors, ministers believe that they can start a small civil war on their borders in their country. So, when presidents continue to relate to ICC as they have done over the past 10 years, we get far more mini civil wars that can all be taken over by copy terrorists. I don't know what Estonia will do. They have a lot to lose. It's an independent country for about 12 years. No, longer, 20 years or so. I can't recall it. But they have a lot to lose. It's a small country and they are part of the Baltics, and the Baltics as a small continent is also a weak economy. And from the West, we do not have normal access to those countries. And with normal, I mean it's not easy for us to take a train, take a plane and start a part of life in the Baltics. That's due to our mentality, our corruption. The both systems are not flowing together easily. Well, the cleaning up of ICC does not start with the trust fund. It has a key position within the presidency of the state members of ICC, but they are indifferent. They only lie. I don't know how to change it. First, we have the major problem of ICC prosecutor, register and president who enjoy to murder people. That comes first. And then the assembly of state members, and then the victim fund. We have to wait for the results of Estonia. I still hope Urmas Seruma will finally take his plane and fly to the Netherlands and stop his childish behavior in connection with me. I said it before. I know he went to a divorce. I know he had to restart life, and I know this and I know that. But when he starts life at the cost, restart his life at the cost of the lives of Europeans in general, I have to stop him, and I did. And it still hurts, and he knows that. So I leave you here. This is my last video for today. I will make sure that Capo gets this, and then we'll see. So don't judge for angry people in angry war zone. Don't judge on Estonia yet for hosting that seminar, because it's far too early. I'm working on it, and perhaps something good will come out of it that's non-discriminating and will stop the racism and the genocide committed by ICC. Bye.